Welcome back to my Road to Completion Guide for Darksiders Genesis. This is the final episode of the series. This episode will cover missions 14 through 16 on Apocalyptic Difficulty, the Boatman's Labyrinth, and the Wicked Killington fight. Go ahead and complete mission 14 and 15, and then I'll come back in with commentary and explain how to find Wicked Killington.
Whatever he's mining here, it looks dangerous.
Then let's do what we can to stop him. This operation is massive. Moloch has made the most of his turn here.
Yeah, there's no quick way to do this one.
A wall this big always has something fun on the other side.
I've seen.
I'm gonna leave that one.
We destroy!
We should keep moving. The foreman will be deep in the facility.
Do we really have to kill him just for Samael? What do you want to bet the foreman's on the other side?
Light.
Thank you.
to stop this machine, we should journey below.
Guys, I was wondering where all the disposable henchmen were. It's the quiet moments like this that I enjoy the most.
Say that again.
I'm just playing. It's the wholesale evisceration of our enemies that I enjoy the most. Don't worry. It'll be us knocking on his door long before Lucifer can.
Perhaps we'll arrive at the same time, so I can wrap my hands around both their necks.
Yeah. I love how much you love wringing necks.
Hear a power source.
That'll be the thing to blast. This looks promising.
Thank you.
stopped. Let's see if our intuition was correct. Let's return to the surface. The blades have stopped.
I love vandalizing demon junk.
To the foreman.
You Samael's guy?
Samael is a pissant compared to Lord Moloch.
Ooh, well, I'm gonna tell him you said that.
Time to grind you up, runt. Horse meat is Moloch's favorite.
I'm gonna kill you just for making easy horse jumps.
Stood against us. You are meaningless.
Damn, boy! You still got it!
Huh?
put our enemies at a severe disadvantage if we were to disable them.
You don't have to ask me twice. Looks like they know we're here.
Let them come.
Lord Moloch demands their corpses.
I gotta admit, I like their enthusiasm. Interrupt your pet talk. It was really intimidating. Why'd you have to go and make it weird?
Thank you. There's no end to him!
Keep fighting! We will drown Moloch in a river of blood if need be.
Damn war! Where have you been?
Secret of Moloch's power.
Get a whiff of that gun smoke.
This is the blood.
Uh-oh.
The only way to face off against Wicked Killington is to open all the trickster doors, and the final door can be found at the end of this platforming sequence. There are more coins along the way if you still need to pick up the Mint 3 trophy. After opening the last trickster door, you'll get the Gatekeeper trophy, plus an outlaw's full health stone, Conqueror's full health stone, and outlaw's last abyssal armor shard, which will give you an additional creature core slot. Now that we've opened all the trickster doors, we can face off against Wicked Killington. You have to keep an eye on your health during this fight because he can deal a massive amount of damage in a very short time. His main attack has a ton of reach, very similar to Moloch, so you'll need to dodge through his attack to stay safe. If at any point you feel overwhelmed by his attacks, use World Ender to gain temporary invincibility. He's also very quick, but he gives off audio cues just before he attacks, so use this to your advantage. If Strife dies, run around the edge of the arena with War and use Stone Skin to protect against incoming damage. Make sure to pick up the Wicked Killington Creature Core when the fight is over to unlock the Collector Trophy.
Stop! was mad.
To unlock the next trophy, we need to pick up every boatman's coin inside of the boatman's labyrinth. So it doesn't matter if you already have the Mint 3 trophy, you still need to collect all the coins. Before we tackle Mission 16 on Apocalyptic difficulty, we need to get the Blade Master trophy. We can unlock this trophy by defeating Moloch without taking any damage. You may have accidentally unlocked this trophy when we farmed for his creature cores in a previous episode. If you already have this trophy, you can skip this step of the guide. Set the difficulty to casual so we can deal more damage, and remember to dodge through his attacks to stay safe. When he fills the arena with crystals, use World Ender for invincibility. Getting hit during this fight will not void the trophy, only when you take damage. I'm telling you this because I've been hit before by the crystals, but didn't lose any health, and was still able to get the trophy. I'm assuming this is a glitch, or maybe specific portions of the crystals' hitbox only knock you back without dealing any damage. I'm really not sure. Just be aware of this during the fight.
Promised victory.
I'm sorry. Did you need that?
After you get the Blade Master trophy, complete mission 16 on Apocalyptic difficulty to unlock the following trophies: Full of Hell, The Promised End, and the Platinum trophy, Not Alone. Thanks for watching my Road to Completion guide for Darksiders Genesis. My name is Exonovant, and I'll see you in the next one. Be good.
Going to do this all day.
on with it.
Sword!
If you enjoy my videos and would like to support my work, you can do so at Patreon. I offer a ton of rewards from behind-the-scenes coverage, RTC visual guides and workbooks, even early video access. Pledges start at $1 a month, and for those of you who support me already, I greatly appreciate it.